Ladies and gentlemen, please clear the track for our graduates. Please clear the track so our graduates can enter. Please rise for the graduates. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, you may be seated. Good evening. My name is Maggie Dyer, and as the first honorarian of the senior class, it is my pleasure to welcome you to the Banks County High School Class of 2019 graduation ceremony. At this time, I would like to recognize the members of the Banks County Board of Education. I would like to introduce our Banks County Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Ann Hopkins, and Assistant Superintendents, Ms. Joy Edwards and Dr. Hank Ramey. Mr. Anthony Siebold, Chairman of the Board of Education, Mr. Shane Roberts, Vice Chairman, and members Ms. Atha Dalton, Dr. Mark Stroud, and Mr. Wes Whitfield. I would also like to recognize the administration of Banks County High School, Principal Ms. Christine Bray, and Assistant Principals Mr. Mike Brown and Mr. Josh Ryder, as well as the entire BCHS faculty and staff. I would like to recognize our honored guests for the evening, the parents of the class of 2019. To recognize each graduate's family, please stand when your graduate's name is called and remain standing until the entire row has been recognized. Again, I'd like to thank you for all being here and for joining us in the excitement of Banks County High School's class of 2019 commencement exercises. If everyone would please rise and remove their caps for the presentation of the flag. Would everyone please join us in the Pledge of Allegiance? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated. I would like to start by saying congratulations to my fellow classmates of 2019. We have come a long way, and we've looked towards to May of 2019 since we were 5 years old. We have all grown up together, and some of us may have been in kindergarten together. It has been a long journey, but we have been together, and all our hard work pays off tonight. From learning how to play the recorder in fourth grade to having to balance equations and chemistry that we could never do, we've all done it together, and it's molded us into well-rounded individuals. While graduation is a time to celebrate past successes, it is also a chance to reinvent yourself. You're no longer restrained to who you were in high school. The labels placed on you no matter. This is your chance to make the most of yourself, and it's up to you how you will live your lives. I hope and pray that each and every one of you prosper in college, a new job, or wherever this journey takes you. Never let anyone hold you back from your dreams. So if you don't know, I ran cross country throughout middle and high school. I never really enjoyed the running part, but my coach and teammates made it kind of fun. The region championship race in my freshman year was awful. It was the worst rainy day ever. The meet should have probably been canceled, but Coach Foster had already tortured us in the rain enough that it was nothing. Our trail back in these woods is dreaded by runners all over the state, and I think that day was even worse because it was so muddy. All of my teammates, and especially me, fell several times, and by fell I mean wiped out. But after these falls, we didn't stay down. We got back up. We didn't win this race, but it's still one of the most memorable ones whenever I think back. In the Bible, Hebrews 12:1 says, "Let us run the race with perseverance that is marked out for us." I pray that all of you have a perfect life, but in reality, it's not going to be perfect. You're going to fall down sometimes and have hard times and struggles. when these hard times come, you have to get back up and keep trying. My mom always told me as a child when I was struggling with the loss of my dad that it was okay to be sad, but it was okay to be happy too. The hard times won't last, and there will always be a light at the end of the tunnel. Make good choices, work hard for what you have, and look to the Lord for guidance, and you will excel. I wish you all the best. Congratulations again. Now I would like to introduce our class of 2019 salutatorian, Miss Ansley Hatcher.
Good evening, ladies, gentlemen, classmates, friends, family, and faculty. Tonight, we celebrate the graduation of Banks County's class of 2019. It has been a long 13 years to get to this point, but we are finally here. And each of you here tonight has made an impact on us and who we have become. Let me begin by first congratulating all of our graduates tonight. It has been no easy task to get here. The past 4 years, I have spent my time cramming the night before a test, drinking way too much coffee, and worrying too much about the difference between a 99 and a 100. We have all had to struggle with balancing school, with work, sports, and our social lives, with barely any time left over to sleep. However, all of our hard work is paying off, and we are finally here. I ask you all to think back to August of 2015 when we first walked into the halls of Banks County High School as freshmen. We thought we had it all figured out. However, we really had no idea what was about to happen. As freshmen, we were so excited to have more freedom, but then we realized how much more responsibility we had. Graduation seemed so far away. Then sophomore year, we couldn't wait to drive. The next year, we became juniors, and we realized we should probably start thinking about our futures or getting a part-time job, and we stressed over the SAT and what colleges to apply to. But our senior year, the one we thought would never get here 13 years ago, has now come and gone. In the past 4 years, we have made unexpected friendships and grown away from ones we thought would last a lifetime. We have faced obstacles that threatened to squash us, laughed until we cried, became professional procrastinators, overslept, and stayed up all night just to do it over again. We were impacted by amazing friends, inspirational teachers, and supportive families. Along the way, we may have gotten into a little bit of trouble, failed a few tests, or had a couple of stress-induced breakdowns, but we made it. All of the memories, good and bad, have led to this moment, and at the end of the night, we will have all walked across this stage and received our diplomas. Some of you might wonder how your time here at Banks County High School will be remembered. Our time here together as a class will not be remembered by grades, popularity, likes, or favorites, but instead by our relationships. When you look back on your high school days, you will not remember that one test you could have studied a little bit more for, or that big game you won or lost. You will remember how much fun you had goofing off with your friends, the way it felt to play on a team, or how your favorite teacher inspired you. If I had one wish for all of you, it is that you never settle for having your best behind you. Graduating high school is the first of many accomplishments that you will have in your lives. Students, you might be sad that you are saying goodbye to the familiar halls and classrooms. You might be sad that you were saying goodbye to good times with your best friends in the town you know like the back of your hand. Parents, you might be sad that your children are growing up. But I hope that you are also proud because we have worked so hard to get here and there is so much more in store for us. Now, at the end of our careers as high school students, we have an opportunity. Now is our time to take on the world and to find and pursue our passions. And so I say thank you. Thank you to my friends, my family, my teachers, and my community. Thank you to my little brother Chase for always keeping me humble. Thank you to my parents for always supporting me no matter what. Dad, without your ability to make any situation hilarious, I wouldn't have had the strength to push through the stressful times. Mom, without your constant guidance, an occasional email to the school board, I would not be up on this stage. I encourage all of my fellow graduates to thank their families, friends, teachers, and community. You all have shaped us into the people we are today, and for that we thank you. So to quote Michael Scott, good night, God bless America, and get home safe. And now I would like to introduce our class of 2019 valedictorian, Ms. Harley Pardon.
I'm going to be entirely honest. In the few days after the announcements of the top three, I was texting my family to tell them the news, and I had to pause for way too long about how to spell valedictorian. I guess it was a good thing spelling never really factored into my grades. I do have to start off with a few brief thank yous. First and foremost, I have to thank God for graciously allowing me to make it this far. I'd like to thank my brothers, Devin and Dustin, not only for being some of my best friends throughout the years, but also for leaving the brains to me. Thank you to my parents for always providing for me, even through hard times. Without them, I would not be standing here today. Thank you to all my teachers because you all taught me something that I needed to know, whether it was useful in the classroom or in the real world. I have to thank the band and everyone involved for being the most diverse group of fantastic weirdos that I will probably ever be a part of, and especially Drumline for absolutely becoming my family over the past 4 years. And finally, I'd like to thank everyone in the audience for being here to support us because God knows we need it. I'm so humbled to be speaking right now, and I'm amazed to see us all in our caps and gowns. It was like Christmas break ended and we all started counting down the days to May 24th. And now it's finally here and most of us will never see each other again. We've grown up together and worked hard for 12 years, and tonight we're all going to get our diplomas and then we'll never be high schoolers again. Most of us are relieved. I know that I am. I know our futures are going to hold so much, and I hope I don't have to tell you that you're going to be okay. Some of us came into tonight knowing exactly where we'll be in August, and some of us don't know where we're going to be next week, and that's okay. Graduation is definitely the first big end to a chapter, but it doesn't even come close to what's going to happen in the next 12 years. Beginnings always hide themselves in ends. Any of my friends or anyone I've ever given advice to, really, can testify to the fact that I have one solid saying about tough decisions. No matter what you do, you have to make sure you're happy. But sometimes knowing what's going to make you happy is hard. We only started driving cars 2 years ago, some of us, like me, less than that. But now, most of us are moving out and making the biggest decisions of our lives so far. We go from being told what clothes to wear and asking for permission to go to the bathroom straight out into the real world, expected to know exactly what to do and what we want. But whether we're going to college, taking a year off, or already have a job lined up, we're all going to have similar experiences. It's scary, honestly. I can absolutely admit that I'm scared. But I have a lot of hope, and I hope you all do too. I hope all of you are blessed with friends like I am, and that those people support you in all your choices like mine do. I hope if you don't have people like that supporting you, that you find some, because they are absolutely so important. I hope if you're moving off to college by yourself, that you get to know your roommate over the summer, and you end up being great friends. I hope if you're staying here for whatever reason that some days you find time to discover new places, whether they're 10 minutes down the road or in a whole different country. I hope you have good memories here, whether those are long bus rides or having fiestas in Spanish or playing magic with your friends even though you don't understand the rules at all. But I hope high school is not your best years. I hope they only get better. I hope from tonight forward you make the most out of everything that life hands you. And no matter what it is or what anyone else has to say about it, you do what you love to the best of your ability. I hope in all you do that you're happy. Congratulations and thank you. Now I would like to introduce Dr. Mark Stroud of the Banks County Board of Education.
Excellent. I would like to introduce Ms. Christine Bray, principal of Banks County High School. She will be handing out diplomas assisted by her assistant principals, Mr. Mike Brown and Mr. Josh Ryder. Dr. Ann Hopkins, superintendent of the Banks County School System, will be congratulating the class of 2019 along with Ms. Joy Edwards and Dr. Hank Ramey, assistant superintendents, Ms. April Loggins and Ms. Mary Boykin, Banks County High School counselors, and the members of the Banks County Board of Education. Now, would the first row of the class of 2019 graduates please rise to receive your diplomas? Harley Marie Pardon, class of 2019 valedictorian. Ansley Brooke Hatcher, class of 2019 salutatorian. Charles Black Construction Company Scholarship. Maggie Caitlin Dyer, class of 2019 first honorarian. Banks County American Legion Scholarship. Vasco and Reba Parker Memorial Scholarship. Emily Rose Adams, honor graduate. Princess Catherine Anaya, Banks County Chamber CVB Technical Scholarship. Nathaniel Bryce Applegarth. Tristan Clint Armour. Haley Nicole Armstrong. Luis Enrique Arteaga. Charles Timothy Bagwell. Kelsey Chantel Bagwell. Matthew Scott Bain. Avery Lane Berryhill. Jeffrey Ford Biggin. Tori Ann Biggin. Peyton Marie Black, honor graduate. Olivia Yvonne Bolton, honor graduate. Mark Alexander Bonds. JC Noel Bowen, honor graduate, signed with Georgia College for basketball. Positive Athlete Award, Greater Hall FCA Female Athlete of the Year Award, Meadows Surgical Arts Scholarship, Cody Gowder Memorial Scholarship, Mended Heart Scholarship, Banks County Board of Education Scholarship, Gene Higginbottom Memorial Scholarship, American Red Cross High School Scholarship, the Woodman Life Focus Forward Scholarship, Megan Rochelle Bowman, honor graduate, Constitutional Offers Associate of Georgia Scholarship, Charles Black Construction Company Scholarship, Caitlin Marie Boyer, honor graduate, Samuel Andrew Boyer, Logan Lee Bramlett, Chase Edwards Brown, Uriah Antonia Brown, Ryan Clay Burnett, Austin Lee Burrell. Caitlin Virginia Burrell, honor graduate. Stephen Alexander Bushore. Aubrey Lynn Cagle. Kaylee Nicole Kane. Annalie Grace Carlisle. Emmanuel Seth Carney. Aaron Crawford Cash. Kerrigan Haley Chastain. Mason Kai Shervaney, honor graduate. Tessa Aubrey Christopher, honor graduate. Mackenzie Deanna Estelle Clark. Hunter. Graduate, East West Banks Excellence Award. Seth Todd Coker. Lydia Christian Cosper, honor graduate. Banks County Board of Education Scholarship. Shorter University Provost Scholarship. Shorter University. Anthony Jamie Cruz, honor graduate. Signed with Emmanuel College for Wrestling. Emmanuel College Pinnacle Scholarship. Cheyenne Faith Dalton. Shelby Lynn Dalton, Banks County.